guys. I just want to put together a YouTube video for the local goodness, Suck Creek. If you live in Chattanooga, you work a day job, whatever, this is probably your go-to quick class five. I mean, top to bottom, it maybe takes 15 minutes if you know where you're going. Any local that's up and coming and you're wondering kind of maybe what may be in Suck Creek, what is it like at a normal medium flow, this is the video for you. I'm just gonna name all the major rapids and I'll kind of just do all the fun little moves that I like. I'll maybe splice in a move or two from a separate lap. This creek just has so much history. They've been running it for so freaking long. You can run it pretty high and there's other sections above it, South Suck, that you can run into it whenever it gets super high. Like this creek's manky. If you wanna take this video and kind of use my moves that bring me true happiness and joy after a day at work in Chattanooga, go for it. But yeah, pretty much stays in for a couple days at least after a rain. This video is at kind of a medium flow of like 0.9. But yeah, this is a cool creek. It just changes every so often, and like there's just been a million different versions of Suck Creek, which is what makes it so interesting. You go and you paddle with somebody else that has been here for a while. They're like, man, that used to be Chicken Leg Joe. I really enjoy the current version and I want to do it justice to you guys. So yeah, that's why I'm making this video. General rules for this creek are just don't touch any of the big rocks on the sides. They might be bad. It's better to not touch the rocks than to maybe find out. Bring your elbow pads and always check for wood. To ask a local who runs Suck Creek if there's a wood report, should be good to go. But yeah. Snippet in right here. This is one of my buddies who tried to make this move. It's a really simple move, and off far to the left is a pretty bad sieve that collects water super often. And did I say collect water? Collects wood, guys, and some water. But it's super nasty, and if you don't make the move, it can get really bad. So yeah, here's a video of that when you mess it up. And all you have to do is make it. that rapid. You guys just saw that Shitbird Alley pretty fast whenever its higher flows. And the next rapid that you usually want to get out before is called Knucklehead. It's this like maybe 10-foot drop. It lands on a rock, and it's a pretty slim line. But you know, there's a lot of debate in the Chattanooga community of, do we remove the rock? Do we keep it? I'm personally on the keep it side because it is runnable. Fun fact: there's stories of a redneck going off an inner tube or somebody, I don't know who it was, and they broke both of their legs. But yeah, a lot of people hip check this rock, and. But yeah, there's big debate. Do we keep it? Do we leave it? The river is runnable without portages, but